Hello student, after completion of the muscle of the pectoral region, let's see the muscle which is present into the posterior to the pectoral region. The muscle which is present posterior to the pectoral region, that the name of the muscle, that is also called the muscles connecting with the scapula with the vertebral column. It consists of the five muscles, and these five muscles are divided into the two groups, that is the superficial layer which consists of two muscles, that is the trapezius and the latissimus dorsi, and the deep layer of the muscle, it consists of three muscles, that is the levator scapulae, the rhomboidus minor muscle and the rhomboidus major muscle. So let's see the details of the muscles which is connecting the scapula with the vertebral column, or the muscles of posterior to the pectoral region. So here in this diagram you can see that is the superficial layer of the muscles which is present back to the pectoral region. So first muscle, that is the trapezius, here you can see that is the large muscle, and the second muscle, that is the latissimus dorsi. So this one. So let's see the details of this muscle. So first the trapezius muscle. The origin of the trapezius muscle, here that the muscle is present largely on the back of the pectoral region, and the origin of this muscle, that is the medial one third of the superior knuckle line. So here you can see that is the superior knuckle line, and it is originate from the medial two third of the superior knuckle line. Second one, that is the occipital protuberance. So here that is the elevation of the occipital bone is present, called the occipital protuberance. Third one, that is the ligamentum nucci. So here you can see this line, that is called the ligamentum nucci. And the fourth one, that is the C7 spine. So here you can see that is the cervical vertebrae is present here, and that is from the C7 spine. And the last one, that is the T1 to T12 spine. So here you can see T1 to T12 spine. So here. So from this region, from all the parts of this region related with the vertebral column, that the origin of the muscle that should be occurs. Then the insertion of this muscle, it should be occurs into the three fibers, the upper fibers, the middle fibers and the lower fibers. So firstly, we should have to see the insertion of the upper fibers. So here you can see that is the upper fibers of this muscle, and it is inserted lateral one third of the clavicle. So here you can see that is the clavicle, and it is inserted lateral one third of the clavicle. Second one, that is the middle fiber. The middle fiber, it should be inserted on the upper lip of the crest of spine. So here that is the crest of spine is present, and it is inserted into the upper lip of the crest of spine. And the lower fibers, this one, it is inserted into, that is the deltoid tubercle at the medial end of the spine. So here that is the spinous process, or the spine of scapula is present, and here on the medial side, that is the deltoid tubercle is present. So here that is the insertion of the lower fiber of the trapezius muscle, it should be occurs. Then the nerve supply to this muscle, that is the spinal part of accessory nerve, and also from the C3 to C4 spinal nerves. Then the action of this muscle, that is the upper fiber, it is act as shrinking of scapula. Second, that is the middle fiber, it is act as a retract of the scapula. And the lower fiber, it is act as the rotate the scapula during the round movement of the shoulder. Okay? So this is the function which is done by the trapezius muscle. Then the next muscle, that is the latissimus dorsi. So here you can see that is the latissimus dorsi, that is also the large muscle, and it is originate from origin of this muscle, that is the posterior one third of outer lip of the iliac crest. So here you can see that is the iliac crest is present on both sides. So it is originate from posterior one third of outer lip of the iliac crest. Then second one, its origin is the posterior layer of lumbar fascia. So from this region, that is the lumbar region, here that is the fascia is present, that is called the lumbar fascia. Then spine from T7 to T12. So here you can see that is the T7 to T12 here. and the inferior angle of scapula. Here you can see that is the inferior angle of scapula. So these are the multiple origin of that the muscle. Okay? Then the insertion of this muscle, that is the muscle winds lower border of the teres major muscle. Here that is the teres major muscle is present. So it should be winds around the lower border of the teres major muscle and it should be forming the posterior wall of the axilla. Okay? Then the tendon of this muscle, it is twisted. So here you can see that is the twisting of the tendon of the muscle, it should be occur. And this twisted tendon, it is inserted on the floor of intertubercular sulcus. So here that is the intertubercular sulcus or the bicipital groove is present. So it should be present or inserted into the floor of the intertubercular sulcus. So that is the insertion of this latissimus dorsi muscle. Then the nerve supply, that is the thoracodorsal nerve. And the action of this muscle, that is the adduction, extension and medial rotation of the shoulder. Okay? It is also help in the climbing of the body and also hold the inferior angle of scapula in its constant place. Okay? So here the scapula is present. So during the moment of the shoulder joint, there may be moment of the scapula, it should be occur. So it should be keeps the proper position as it is attached to the inferior angle of scapula. So it should be keeps the proper position of the scapula during the moment of the shoulder. Okay? So that is the muscle, the latissimus dorsi. Okay? Then the next muscle we should have to see, that is the deep layer of the muscle. So here in this diagram you can see that is the three muscle, the levator scapulae, the rhomboides minor and the rhomboides major. This one. So first starts from the levator scapulae. So levator scapulae, this one, it is originate from the transverse process of C1 and C2. So here you can see that is the C1 and C2 transverse process of the vertebra and posterior tubercle of transverse process of C3 and C4. So here that is the C3 and C4. Okay? Then the muscle, it goes downwards and laterally and it is inserted into the superior angle and the upper part of medial border of the scapula. So here that is the superior angle of the scapula is present and that is the medial border of the scapula. Okay? So here that the muscle, it should be inserted. Then the nerve supply of this muscle, that is the dorsal scapular nerve. And the action of this muscle, that is the elevation of the scapula. And it steadies the scapula during the moment of the arm. So that is the two important function which is done by the levator scapulae. As the name suggests, levator means that is the elevation of the scapula. Then the next muscle, the rhomboides minor. So here you can see that is the rhomboides minor muscle. Origin of this muscle, that is the lower part of ligamentum nucci. So here green color you can see that is the ligamentum nucci and here that is the lower part of the ligamentum nucci and spine C7 to T1. So here that is the last cervical spine, that is the C7 vertebra and that is the first cervical spine, that is the T1. Thoracic, first thoracic spine. So it is originate from the spine of C7 to T1. Then the muscle goes downwards and laterally and it is inserted to the spine of scapula. So here you can see the triangular area which is present to the root of spine of scapula. Then the nerve supply of this muscle, dorsal scapular nerve, and the action of this muscle, that is retract the scapula and steadies the scapula. So that is the two function which is done by the rhomboides minor muscle. And the last muscle, that is the rhomboides major. So here that is the large muscle is present, the rhomboides major muscle. So origin of this muscle, that is the spine of T2 to T5. Here you can see that is the T2 thoracic second vertebra, T3, T4 and T5. So till the the fifth thoracic vertebra, the origin of this muscle, and the supraspinous ligament. Okay, then the muscle, it goes downwards and laterally, and it is inserted on the medial border of scapula below to the root of spine of scapula. So that is the root of spine of scapula here, or the spinous process, and this is the medial border. So it is inserted lower to the root of spine of the scapula on the medial border of the scapula. Then the nerve supply, the dorsal scapular nerve, and the action of this muscle, that is rotate the scapula and steadies the scapula. So these are the deep muscles of the posterior to the pectoral region, or the back to the pectoral region.